Hi guys, I'm Priyanshi and I'm a CA final student. Today I have with me Vivek and Gayatri, who are my college friends, and today we're going to discuss a very important topic about CA and CA exams. So there is a lot of myths around failing CA exams, even though it is such a common thing. So today we're going to discuss about how it is okay to fail your exams and how you can overcome it. So Gayatri, I'll start with you. Can you start by talking a little bit about the myths that surround failing CA exams, and you know how there's a lot of confusion about whether or not you will get the articleship of your choice as a result of failing?
The biggest myth in CA, I feel, is that people thinking that you can't get into a top four if you don't pass both the groups in the first attempt. That is so not true. I feel like the decision about writing how many groups and when should solely be dependent on the person, how much they can take and what their appetite is. I feel like one should just think by themselves if they're ready and are willing to take up on the work and pressure to write both at once, or if they feel like giving one at a time is their way to go. And to decide that, it's very personal. Like, you have to think on your own. And of course, you can discuss with your family and, you know, your trusted support system who can help you throughout this.
Some companies do have a policy of taking you within 3 attempts. But those are very few firms. Most of firms do not have certain type of policies. And once you get inside a firm, it really doesn't matter the number of attempts you've taken. It really matters on the quality of your work and how well you'll be able to contribute to that team and your role in the firm. The attempts are not that important, and I feel like it's one of the biggest myths which surrounds the entire CA community, saying that you have to pass within your first attempt to get into the firm which you love.
So Vivek, can you talk a little bit about your experience with the attempts in CA? So I don't want to call it failing, I want to say did not pass or did not clear, because I feel like that is a better term, and failing sounds like so huge. And that's actually not the case with the exams. So can you share a little bit about your experience?
Failure really isn't that old type of logic wherein you'd start to say failure is the stepping stone to success. I really don't believe in that. But failure is something that you fall down. It's normal to fall down. But what's important is to pick yourself back up. You fall down once, you go back, get back up. You fall down twice, you get back up twice. You keep on getting back up. The never giving up attitude is what's required for CA in the end.
For me, when I saw my result, I was completely sad and it really shook me. But what helped me on is the fact that I had a great support system who helped me push myself back up and start studying again, and not just look at this as a sad phase but as a stepping stone to moving ahead. I made sure that I noted down what mistakes I had made earlier and I worked on them, and that's what helped me later on in the future attempts.
Guys, I think I totally agree with what both of you said. It is true that in CA you need to take one step at a time, and it is okay if you do not clear your exam. It's not the end of the world, even though it does feel like that. And Gayatri, what you said about the support system makes a lot of sense, because it really helps to have people around you who can support you during this time. So my third question is something related to this. So once you have understood that you have to write another attempt, there are a lot of expectations and lot of pressure that you face when you have to write your next attempt. So could you share your experience about that?
I feel like for the upcoming attempts, the pressure gets lesser from the people around you, but the pressure starts building more on yourself because of yourself. Because this comes down to proving yourself that this is something that you weren't able to do before and you want to do this now for yourself.
Well, I do agree with you on certain points, Gayatri, but there are certain points I disagree too. When you said that your second attempt is a lot less pressurizing from your parents, okay, that might be right, but the second attempt is a lot more difficult mentally. When you're in your first attempt, And let's say you have passed and you have written one by one, and in your second attempt, there is more pressure because it really says that, oh, you have to pass because you have already passed your first attempt. There is this pressure that surrounds you, which makes it much more difficult, and the motivation is a lot more difficult.
So I think I agree with both of you, and both of you touched upon different points. So, Gayathri, it's true that we are the ones who put pressures on ourselves because our family gets a little more supportive around this time. But Vivek is talking about a little different issue wherein you write both groups in your first attempt and you pass one and fail the other. So it's like a bittersweet kind of moment where you are happy about passing one group and you're upset about passing the other. I mean, not passing the other. So, it makes sense that you do feel the pressure to pass the second group because the first time you were able to pass the first group. So, I totally agree with what both of you said. Okay, so I think now we'll move on to the next question. So, my next question is that how do you find the motivation to study during this time? I know we are motivated enough to study for the next attempt, but there is a constant voice which sometimes troubles us and says that, oh, you failed, you failed. And I feel like that is really a problem when you're trying to study and when you're trying to focus on the subject. So, how did you guys deal with that?
Motivation is something that is highly personal. For me, my reasons might seem shallow. For me, passing my IPCC first group was all about proving my roommates wrong, saying that I am not an idiot. Well, the second attempt was slightly different. A lot of people said that, oh, you got lucky in your first attempt. I don't think you will do the same thing again. It wasn't exactly to prove them wrong. But I gained sort of a self-confidence in myself, and I wanted to prove to myself also that I can actually do it. And on top of that, my parents were very supportive. My dad was someone who did not have a professional qualification, and he talked all around having a professional qualification and how it gives you a certain level of respect. And that respect is something which is really difficult to get, and it really can't be bought with money so easily.
I feel like for me, that voice helped me push harder. So whenever I would study and I would get these thoughts of, you failed before, you won't be able to do this, that was my push to be like, no, I am going to do this now and I'm gonna work on what I missed out before and I'm gonna push forward. And the times when it got really overwhelming, I used to talk, like I mentioned before, my support system. So I used to talk to my friends and then, they would help me get out of my head. And then they would remind me why I'm here and why I really want to pass this exam and what is important for me. And that would push me back to studying and it would keep me motivated.
So I think I completely agree with Vivek that motivation is personal. The same thing that one person takes it to be negative, the other person can take it as a positive thing and take it as a positive motivation. In Vivek's case, it was thinking about what other people will say, and in Gayatri's case, she used the voice in her head as a positive thing. So I think that's a great message to everybody who's watching this. So one other thing that I really don't like about CA is that a lot of people think that if you failed an attempt or if you did not clear an attempt, you are dumb. And that is the last thing that I want to hear for any CA student because I feel like there is a lot of hard work and there's a lot of commitment that goes into actually preparing for an exam and just the fact of deciding to take up this course. So, could you guys share a little bit of your experiences about this and what you guys think about this?
When people say that, are you dumb for not passing the examination? I feel like they're the ones who are dumb actually, not us. CA examination is really difficult, and not passing the attempt doesn't make you dumb. To be honest, I feel like I am more dumber than the friends who haven't passed the exams yet. In all fairness, just because you pass the exam doesn't make you smart, or just failing the exam doesn't make you dumb. It's all subjective. You can be smart or you can be dumb. It's all about how you write the examination and how well you prepare. It doesn't just because you're smart doesn't mean that you will pass the exam in your first attempt. You'll have to put in the hard work, and there are so many steps that you'll have to take towards writing the exam and passing it. It's not just being smart after all.
This is so true. I mean, I've seen a lot of people who think the exact same, but I think it's because they don't realize what exactly happens in the course and they don't realize the amount of portion that is there and the amount that we need to prepare.
So to Vivek's point, I totally agree. It's not about being smart or dumb. There are so many factors that come into it when you're actually preparing for your exam and the circumstances. It's just so many things. So I don't think it can be, you know, brought down to being smart or dumb. And at the end of the day, it's about the knowledge that you gain out of the process. And when you feel, I feel like when you do not clear an exam, it teaches you a lot of things, not just about the course, but also about life in general. Now, this may sound philosophical, but I feel like it is really true. And it, you do grow as a person, you do grow as an individual and a professional. So I feel like it's an important part of the CA course to experience that. So my final question would be, there are a lot of people who feel like quitting because of failing. So what are your thoughts on that?
CA course is a long, strenuous, hard journey, and it's really not that easy. And once you fall down, it really is hard to get back on, get back to shape. And it is really hard. And you should be proud that you can get up and you can do all of this stuff. You can get back up and get back to writing the exams again. It's a difficult thing. But there are few people who quit the exam, and maybe it's a right choice, maybe it's a wrong choice. It is a lot of personal choices which come into play. But in my personal opinion, I feel like what is the most important and most crucial aspect to CA is a never quit attitude. Without that, I don't feel like you'll get anywhere in CA.
See, I feel like quitting CA is a very personal decision. I mean, if your interests are elsewhere, then it's better to focus on that than something that you don't want to. But if you really want to do this course, then it's okay to give 2 or 3 more tries.
Like Gayatri said, it is a personal choice whether you want to quit or not. And again, it is okay to quit something if you feel like your heart is not into it. So I'm not going to talk about whether or not you should quit, but because that is totally up a person's choice. And I think it is out of the scope of this video, so we can talk about it a little later in a different discussion. So I think it was a great session, guys. Thank you so much for doing this. I know the amount of effort you guys put into this and the amount of time it took to actually shoot the entire thing. So thank you so much for doing this. So guys, please do like, share, comment and subscribe. Share this video with all your friends out there. Even though we are talking about failure in CA, it is true for anything that you take up. If you fail at something, it is not the end of the world, even though it does feel like that. And you always have your support system to get back to. So it is important to surround yourself with people who support you. And I think Gayatri and Vivek are two key people in my CA journey. And I think that's why I wanted to do this video with them. So thank you so much, guys. Thank you for watching the video.